But when was the last time you called up your bank or you called up your mortgage broker and you said, can you get me a better deal? When was the last time you tried it on? 9221882. And if you had any success, what did you manage to squirrel your interest rate down to? Doing a little bit of a survey of the office, the range is between about 3.1% up to about 4.5%. So what are you paying? And or when was the last time you had that conversation with the bank? Were they prepared to lower it, and what did they lower it to? The RBA is saying that existing borrowers are being gouged by the banks who are offering new mortgage discounts. Martin North is the principal at Digital Finance Analytics. He's live on the radio this afternoon. Hello, Martin.
Hello, Oliver.
It always seems to be the scenario, doesn't it, Martin, that new customers get better deals than those who've been paying off their mortgage for years and years and years, if not decades.
Yeah, there's no advantage to being loyal to a bank because they are not loyal to you. Essentially, if you've had a loan for, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, you're going to be paying a lot more than if you go somewhere down the road and get a new loan. The banks are desperate to write new business, so essentially all of those cheap loans are for new deals. Existing people are being taken to the cleaners.
So that little sample we conducted here in our office of between about 3.1% and 4.5%, does that sound about right?
Yeah, it does. I run surveys of households with mortgages, and there's a very consistent pattern that people who have had mortgages for a little while are paying a lot more, in some cases up to 1% or more relative to those really new loans. It does vary, of course. If you're on a fixed rate, that's a bit different from a variable rate. But if you're on a standard variable rate loan, the chances are if you've got an older loan, you'll be paying a lot more. And it's not just a few hundred dollars a year. This can really mount up over the years. So it's a very significant saving if you actually take the initiative and essentially first try your existing lender and, put the heart on them, because the chances are they will want to do something, but worst case is then to go shop to somebody else. Mm. Of course, there are costs involved. It's difficult to do. It's, not straightforward, but it's amazing what you can save if you do it.
Is it worth doing it yourself, or should you start to engage that third party, go and have a chat to the mortgage broker? Because he or she can provide you about 12 different options that you can then probably go back to your bank and say, hey, look, at this, if I move Commonwealth to ANZ, I'm going to save 1%, so what are you going to do?
Yeah, well, interestingly, my survey says that if you go to the bank yourself, you may get an even better deal than if you go via a mortgage broker, because not necessarily all mortgage brokers have access to all the deals that are there. So I think my recommended strategy would be have a conversation with your lender, bearing in mind that the advertised rate on the website is nothing to do with the real rate that you can get, right? Mm. So go in with the assumption that they'll give you, 100 basis points off or something and start from there. Sure, mortgage brokers can certainly help if you haven't got the time, but there's no guarantee that they will necessarily get you the better deal. In fact, my research says that mortgages originated by mortgage brokers tend to be a little more expensive relative to ones directly to the banks at the moment.
Is there anything hidden in the cheapest loans? Because the RBA has said that some of those very cheap loans advertised may be around a full 2 percentage points lower the standard variable mortgage rate. Might there be some sort of term and condition in there as well, Mark, that you need to be aware of before you look at the raw number and think that's the lowest I want it?
Yeah, great question. So you've got to make sure you're comparing apples with pears and apples and apples, So, for example, is it a permanent discount, or is it a deep discount just for the first 12 months and then it goes up to a higher rate? There are some of those around at the moment. And you need to look at the terms and conditions. It is unfortunately a relatively complicated process, so lots of questions. Also, bear in mind that there may be exit fees for your existing loan if you decide to switch from one bank to another bank, depending on how long you've had the loan for. And, of course, if you've got a fixed-rate mortgage, in other words, the interest rate is locked in, and you then choose to go off the fixed rate, that could well cost you as well. So there are definitely some trips and traps for the unwary if they're not careful.
My guest is Martin North, the principal at Digital Finance Analytics. Have you recently called up the bank yourself? Have you had any success squirreling down the interest rate? 9221882. The survey of the 6PR office today is somewhere between 3.1% and as high as 4.5%. Where does yours sit? 9221882. Martin, how often should you ask for a rate cut?
Well, my own view is you should be doing it at least once a year because, you know, conditions change. I'd also say to you that the deal you'll get will be determined a bit by your own credit rating and what your loan-to-value ratio is. So if you've got a lot of equity in the property, you probably get a better deal than if you're at a 95% mortgage, for example. And if you've got issues with regards to not paying your bills on time, that could be another reason why your rate could be higher. So there are reasons sometimes why the rates are higher. But if you are a meat and potatoes, you know, pay every month on the nail sort of mortgage holder, and you haven't switched or looked at switching over the last year or two, it's worth picking up the phone and having a go because you will definitely save quite a lot of money.
Many economists don't predict rates going anywhere this year, probably staying on hold as they are. But if they were to budge down a little bit further, is that the time you get on the phone the next day and say, oi, what can you do? What do you need to wait and let it shake out for a little while?
Well, you know, the chances are if rates were cut again, the banks wouldn't pass the whole amount on because the margins now that the banks are operating under are very, very compressed. So I would almost put a note in the diary, you know, at the end of the Christmas break, before you get back to work, make that call and see what you can do. Because it amazes me how few people shop around for banking services more generally. You know, it's not just the mortgage, but even other accounts too. And it's because we're a bit lazy sometimes. It's because it's not very straightforward. But actually, there is a significant opportunity for those who actually grasp the nettle and go do it.
While they're so low, should we be fixing our rates or just continue to ride this wave?
Well, I don't think there's much chance of rates rising in the short to medium term. And in fact, if rates, you know, do move down slightly on a variable, you might actually get a little bit of a benefit from that. So I think in the current climate, there's not a lot of reason to want to fix. I think I'd probably be thinking of just, you know, keeping with the low rates. The Reserve Bank's pretty much said the rates aren't going anywhere for at least 2, 3, 4 years. So it'll be a long, slow rise if it changes. So, I'm not sure that fixed rates these days are worth pursuing. Also, bear in mind that there will be some costs potentially wired into those fixed rates that you can avoid if you get a variable rate.
Great to chat to you, Martin. Thank you so much.
Good to talk to you.
Martin North, the Principal of Digital Finance Analytics. The RBA said in its latest statement on the monetary policy, the loans have an interest rate that is around 40 basis points higher than new loans. 40 basis points higher. So you are potentially paying a lot more than somebody who signs up to a new loan. Now, that is somewhat of an obvious statement today, but you're being advised here from the RBA. Go and have that chat. When have you had that chat? Have you called up the bank and asked for a better deal, and were they forthcoming with a better deal? Or have you shopped around, moved banks recently, and found yourself squirreling the bank down to about 3.1%? Can anybody better that? 3.1%, the interest rate that they're paying. That's the lowest we got around the 6PR office today, as high as 4.5%.